close that back door, don't want no snake shit around me. Circle only getting smaller, built this thing from the ground. Who built this? Me, that's who. Who put all this shit together, bitch? Me, that's who. Who built this? Me, that's who. Who put all this shit together, bitch? Me, that's who.
You're boxed in, like, so if you say, ah, this is a distraction. Ah, conspiracy theorist. Conspiracy theorist. No, you're not about it. It's clear as day, it's a distraction. It's clear as day. Nah, man, you're a conspiracy theorist. So I'm like, damn. Then all this AI, all these, you know, the inflation thing. So, like you said, what money was worth back then to what it's worth now, people have no real sense of comfort. You see what I'm saying? And you're just thinking to yourself, what are they going to do to change the direction of this? But I don't think they're going to do anything. I think it's what you said previously. We're going into an era of 15-minute cities.
Yeah,
you can see how they're rolling them things out, because even with the congestion charging, bro, they don't make the money from the actual you paying it. They make the money from people who don't pay it.
Don't pay, yes.
Yeah, man. they make the money from people who don't pay it, because if you don't pay it, it can easily build to like £1,000 if you let it go on long enough. Mm-hmm. And you see what I mean? So it's absolutely crazy. It's crazy what's going on, man. I'm just looking on. I'm like, would the direction of the country change, or how will it change? If you look at it and you try and map out a plan, let's say you're the prime minister and you try and map out a plan, how can you change the direction? You can't. How can you?
Oh, we're talking real thing now, then.
Real
thing? I'm prime. Let's say
you're the prime minister now. Bear a few things in mind.
Yeah.
This episode is sponsored by Supreme of the UK. Click the link in the description and support the broadcast.
The asylum seekers that are here.
Yeah, yeah, yeah.
That's reached a maximum. I'm going to keep it 1,000 with you.
Yeah, yeah.
The housing crisis and the financial crisis. What can be done in the near future to change the trajectory of the country? What would you do?
Let's go, I love man. It, Mark. I love it. Vote me in, boss. Vote me in. That's all I'm saying. We need the coalition behind. But let me outline the thing. As you've highlighted, those are the major issues. Let's go in reverse. Utilities and the cost of living has risen like the sun back in the day. And I'm not saying shit was perfect back then, but we had something called MEB, Midlands Electricity Board, you know, which was... At that point, it was a private limited company. But prior to that, it was a governmental organization. Pardon self, just like gas, just like the railways. Remember the old school railway sign that they used to have up everywhere? Yeah?
Yeah.
We're bringing that shit back in-house, boss. Margaret Thatcher and them sold or privatized all the thing they made, the little Fed for themselves, blah, blah, blah. I'm bringing this shit back in-house. Yeah? Anyone that's locked up, Mark? Anybody who's locked up, you see this community service thing? That's extending to prisoners. And they're going to be... There's not going to be no potholes no more, sibling.
Yeah.
No more potholes.
Good idea.
No more uneven somes, pathways, no graffiti on the thing. We're talking about entering West Midlands. Not even just West Midlands. Let's talk the whole thing from the Prime Minister. Yeah? We're talking about going places and you're not seeing... You'll see a difference in regards to areas. Oh, this is a posh area. This is a middle class area. And this is maybe a little bit of a poor area. But we're not going to see graffiti everywhere. We're not going to see fly tipping everywhere. Because I've got people in place to deal with that there. You know what I mean? We're going to bring things in-house. We ain't going to have all the imports. Remember the look of science made in Britain with a look of British flag? Yeah. I'm bigging up British manufacturers. I'm investing in this little island. I don't care if you're an immigrant, a migrant, an illegal immigrant who's now got their stay. If you've got something to add to this dear country, you're coming on board. So that's that microcosm. Then we're talking about if you touch women, children, or you kill people, that's it. If it's proved within a shadow of a doubt, we're bringing back the death sentence. And I'm going to have every Friday, or I'm going to pick a day, every certain day, yo, you could be watching, you could be playing a game, and it just gets interrupted. And we're watching live executions. Live executions are going in. And within a year, Mark, I'm saying that crime rate of all that nastiness that's going in, that's proliferating this year, the man-a-man on train with big sword things, that's plummeting. Because they're seeing their bridges hanging from damn sums or getting in, however we want to do it. But yes, you're going to be forced to see that shit, boss. There's going to be a consequence of your actions. And we're going to clean this thing up. Also, there's no four-year terms and this and that. There's none of this party business. We're just going to have a governmental system specifically aimed at doing what it's supposed to do, which is maintain this system. They ain't going to get paid all this stupid money and all these expenses and all this stupid shit. There's going to be none of that business. None of that's going on. Football players getting paid 1.2 or 30, all this. No, we're going to switch that shit straight around. You see Dr. Singh, Bafrati, something, something. He's going to be in the newspapers. He's going to be the $65 million man. The local nurse, Mary, she's going to have £1 million every year. The doctors, the people who are put, the firemen, real policemen, they're going to get the money, Mark. They're going to be the heroes. They're going to be the stars.
Instead, we clap for them. We clap for them through that COVID thing. But at what point, now all of that, I agree with all of that. I agree with all of that. Because even with that knife thing, people are like, oh my God, look what's happening to Britain. I'm like, yo, all you have to do with that is give that youth 15 without the possibility of parole. Let's see how much of his brethren want to carry a knife then. Like, I'm talking about not without even doing the act. Just, you got a knife and you, boom, 15 years. And I agree with you. Free labor. Free that. And you know what men say? Oh, that's against human rights. Bun all of that.
Bun it.
But if you choose that life, then you know what's going to happen. You've made a choice. Mm-hmm. So it should be like, yeah, man, it should be, there should be no, them kind of man there, like you said, instead of just sitting around in prison all day, bring their man out.
Yes.
Get some kind of electrical device or something that if a man tries to run away, it just shocks his claw.
Shocking blood fire.
Until it just drops down. You get me? It just shocks down his claw. And then when he drops down now, yeah, a man just come and say, yeah, man, you see that? You tried to run away? You can't run away. Like some kind of dog collar or something that as you come out of the zone, it just puts you to sleep.
Yes. Then simple thing.
And them man would be there getting, would be cleaning up the roads and doing all of this and doing all of that.
Yeah.
They gotta kill this inflation somehow. Also, they have to. Ooh. It's got nothing to do with Russia at this point. Nothing. They're pulling the wool and talking about the effects of the pandemic. But you gotta think, we the people didn't make no decisions about that pandemic. None. Mm-mm. We didn't make none. All we're seeing in society now is division. Division on these news topics. Division on all of this stuff that's going on. Like, if I was ever to be working in a public setting, I'm not conversating about none of that stuff.
None of it.
I'm not conversating about none of that stuff because people have their own agendas. Everyone sees the world differently. But it's mad, man. It's mad what's going on in Britain. Can't lie. Mad what's going on in Britain. Like, I never thought I'd see the day that Britain would get to a level where it's squeezing the people the way it is. And you can see that the benefit system, that's why they used to dub it the web system, innit? Because what happens when a fly or something gets caught in a web? It don't escape, does it?
Stop.
So that's why they call it that, because a lot of people that are stuck in that system, they've purposely mapped it out. They almost know the environment you're in, the way people think. You know what I mean? It's crazy when you really think about it. And that's what I'm saying, in today's world, what they've tried to roll out over the last, since about 2016, they've tried to roll out a lack of accountability kind of thing. Like, I did this, but I didn't want to do it. I did it because I needed the money and that person's got money. So that's why I did it. I'm a victim. So they've brought in that way of thinking now. So there's a lack of accountability too. So it's just one big pot of issues while someone somewhere is benefiting off of all of this.
Benefiting, yes.
Like, there's other groups that are benefiting off all of this that ain't What's the white girl's version of Sexy Red? What's the white girl's version of that? And I know a lot of people use her as an example, and I know that's unfair because she's a player, but she is one of the biggest female rappers now. And what is the white version of that type of degeneracy?
It's obviously I'm not that, you know, tapped in popular culture, but I don't think there clearly isn't, because the original man and the original woman are here to promote debauchery and death, whereas every other nation can borrow elements of that cool culture, remove the maybe death and debauchery, and maybe just have a little bit of debauchery, just a little smidgen, and we'll have it for Taylor Swift, we'll have it for damn Perry, whoever the hell's popular. I don't know about anybody or any of them people, them, but they'll just retain the little bits and they'll make the nice flowery music, the dreary foolishness, and become mega successful, sibling. That's our job. Well, that's the job they've put in place. And us, I'll use us, even though we're not doing it, we're happy to embrace it because market's about the bag. I want to be a rapper, man. I want to be successful. I want my name to be everywhere. I want my face to be everywhere. I want those experiences I've seen other rappers have. So I'm prepared. You want me to sell my ass? You want me to tell people I've been selling my ass? You want people to talk about eating ass? And I will do it, man, because I want to be successful. I will be number one. I'll be on the NBA halftime show talk. What's that? The look of light skin girl in see-through tights jigging around with a good... Huh?
Oh, you're talking about Ice Spice.
It's infuriating, man.
And she's only like 23 as well.
This is what it's, and they're so young. Why they do what? Yeah, man. What are their parents? Who raised these people, sibling?
Listen to what they say. Listen to how they speak. All that Ice Spice ever says anytime you see her, and again, we're not highlighting Ice Spice. We're just highlighting, you know, players. These are not the actual problem. They're just players. But what does Ice Spice say every time he's here? Bitch, I'm a baddie. I get what I want. Like, what kind of things going on in today's world?
Yeah.
Like, it's like, just because you look good, man is supposed to just shower you with gifts, shower you with money. And that is such a dangerous narrative. But I'm going to say one thing. This is the realest thing I'm going to say on this episode of Saturday Stream. Men with daughters, we've got the hardest job in today's world, especially if you're black. We got the hardest job. Our job is going to be like playing tug of war with Goliath. Because you have to try and pull your daughter away from certain narratives, because while you're trying to show her that certain things are wrong, she shouldn't do this, she shouldn't do that, the poison has spread to maybe her friends and everything, and it might be you one against 100 people. Mm. And it's so sad. So that's why when I jump on, I know sometimes I can be a bit harsh with it. Let's just put it like that. But the reason why I do that is because I can't allow people to change my opinion on how I see these things. You can't sell yourself, man. You can't sell yourself. You just can't do that as a man or as a woman. You just can't do that. You can't sell yourself, man. And it's hard because we've grown up listening to this music. We've grown up listening to Bashment, listening to rap,